Welcome back to Fortnite Battle Royale. Googly eyes. The glider's pretty cool. Silly, stupid, but I like it. That's what this game does really well. Silly and stupid. Today's video is kind of a how to win video, but it's mainly focused on one thing and one thing purely, and that is your aiming. And that is... Oh, weaken that guy. That is because a lot of people ask, hey, I'm making the switch from console to PC. I'm kind of struggling. What can I do better? How do I aim a little bit more accurately? And I can completely relate with you on that. Because when I started playing CSGO, which I didn't play much of because I sucked giant balls and I didn't have fun getting murdered all the time because I didn't have a good computer and I just wasn't very good. I didn't like it a lot either, so I didn't want to put the time in to try to get better. I was looking at videos how to improve, how to aim better in Fortnite. So, we're going to go over that today, and I hope I can offer a little bit of advice for you and give you a little bit of help. First thing I want to tell you, find a sensitivity you're comfortable with and stick with it, okay? That might seem rather obvious. Where is this man? I think he's outside. I'm not entirely sure. Maybe he's out here? Find a sensitivity you like and stick with it. That is an important feature if you want to get better with aiming. Because a lot of people tend to struggle with their aim. Because they try to switch it around too much. And I understand why. People seem to watch other players play, whether it's a pro player or just someone they think is really good, and they're like, well, that guy plays on this, I should play on that. Find something you're comfortable with. I'm gonna tell you this ahead of time as well. Higher sensitivity players tend to have better close range engagements, and that's mainly because he's way over there. We're gonna ignore him. There's a lot more loot here. That's mainly because they can turn quickly and build quicker overall. So higher sensitivity typically is going to be a stronger, God, I have a lot of C4, a stronger close range engagement for you. But lower sensitivity is going to benefit you a lot more when it comes to aiming consistently at range. Now, even though I have a lower sensitivity and I go for accuracy at distance more so than the building fights, I can still build. I'm not a horrible builder. It's just if I go up against some players that have very high sensitivities, I'm going to struggle, and I just want to let you know that ahead of time, because if you're going to go for something like that, if you think you're more of a builder player, you might want to go with a little bit higher sensitivity. I play on 800 DPI, personally, and I play on 0.04 mouse sensitivity, 0.32, is it scoped or aiming? Let me check just to make sure so I don't get this wrong for you guys. 0.32, okay, so 0.04 mouse, ADS is 0.32, scoped is 0.42. So when it gets really close range, it can be difficult for me to keep up with some players. Hello, Scar. I like that a lot. And this is one of my weaknesses actually right here is an SMG. Now, I can hipfire an SMG close range, but when it comes like, I can go like this and turn pretty quickly. But when it comes to following somebody while ADSing, I'm much slower. And so it's difficult for me to ADS close range and follow people. So I typically rock double shotgun or just shotgun. If I do use an SMG, it's almost always hip-fired. I just can't keep up with people's rapid movement close range while ADSing. So a lot of my mid-range fights come down for me to just hip-fire or rely on an explosive, like a shot, you know, rocket launcher, whatever. So if you play... Oh, what happened over here? Where are all these people going? If you play high sensitivity, you probably will be better with building, and you can probably ADS close range. If you play lower sensitivity, you probably have better accuracy long range, but you might struggle in the close range fights a little bit more until you're very comfortable with it. So those are the two types of sensitivities you're going to see most often. Okay. Well, this is interesting. All this shit happened? Oh, here he is, found him. There we go. No problem. Whoa! 7 minis, brother! Thank you very much, sir. I'm not gonna build out here, I'll just go inside. So those are the two types of sensitivities you're really gonna see, the meta for sensitivity in general. And that's important to note, because if you are a low-sense player like myself, you know that you kind of have a disadvantage going up against the high sensitivity players when it comes to close range fights. And if I get into a build fight, I have to remember that I'm not going to be able to outbuild those people too easily. It's going to be really difficult for me. So a lot of times I like to make sure I really weaken people before I get near them, because there's a good chance they're going to outbuild me. So I want to make sure I hit them a few times before pushing. And that's just a smart play in general anyway. Weaken the players before you push them. But much more so for people who rely on rifles a lot, like myself. All right, we hear one person over here. Something else that's really going to help you with aiming. He's not there. One more here. So, go for the hip fire. Close range. We talked about that. I could pick up the sniper right now. I'm not going to because I'm close range still with this other player. I don't want to drop that for a sniper just yet until I have killed the other guy close range to me. We can leave that down there for now. He's running in and out of the rooms down here. There we go. Let's get his loot and then we'll get the sniper. We're going to drop our grenades for it though anyway, so. We're going to keep both our close range weapons for now. We saw a player head off over to the right over there. I don't know if he's still over there, but we're going to go check him out, see if we can get to him. Another thing that helps for accuracy a lot is going to be your actual computer and your monitor. And I say this, unfortunately, it's going to come down to money if you can purchase these things. But if you have a computer that can play at 150, 200 FPS, it feels a lot more smooth and a lot better than playing at 60s, 70s, 80s. And I never knew that until I actually got a better computer. But it does matter and it does help a lot. And I say a monitor matters because if you're playing on a 1 millisecond response rate, 144 hertz monitor, it's easier, more smooth as well to keep track of people and to track them overall with your weapon and to stay accurate. So your sensitivity does kind of have to do with your equipment. As far as mouse and keyboard go, that can be preference. There's some people that play with gaming mouses like myself. There are people that play with like $5 mouses and they're perfectly fine. There's a guy behind me shooting a crossbow. We're just gonna push this guy. Okay, he's up there. We're good. This guy was weakened down 150 HP. He's got 50. If he has too many, he goes up to 100. We should easily be able to kill him still, though, without a problem. That's a different player entirely. He might have killed the person I was shooting at. We're going to go over here, heal up. He might have got the person I was looking at. If he did, I don't see the loot. Someone's still trying to crossbow me. I'm just going to pretend I don't see him. I do see him. Maybe. No, I don't. It's a scarecrow. I lied. We're going to go up top, take the loot, upgrade my SMG to a blue. That's another guy who shot at me off to my left here. We're okay. This is the guy we weakened. So this guy's probably not a lot of health. There we go. Pretty easy. We're going to stick to two close range weapons. No splode for now. We just got to walk a little bit ways. We still have crossbow man shooting at us from somewhere. These might have gotten closer at this point because he probably realized that his crossbow is not too hot and he wants to get near me to hit me with something different, but I don't know where he is. So we're just going to keep walking this way. If he was right here, he seems like a noob. If he was a good player, he probably would use an AR at this point with first shot accuracy instead of using the crossbow over and over. So my guess is if he is a newbie player, he probably hasn't gone all the way to zone yet. Maybe he has. I kind of hope he does, because I don't want to fight outside zone with no type of actual health healing and just shields. So I'm hoping he doesn't shoot me in the back here, but we'll see. So the things to talk about, I've talked about mainly, your DPI is part of your setup as well. So if you have a mouse that can automatically alter DPI, for example, I use a Logitech G403. I like it. I'm at 800 DPI right now. I can click a button on the mouse, 1600, 3200, 400, 800 again. So I can alter mine very quickly, which is nice, but it's just something to consider. Your DPI does matter. This guy's going to die, whoever's down low. These guys are roughly in zone, though. I'm hoping that he falls down. I don't want to have to go down against that. Or maybe he comes down now. Yeah, he did. Cool. So I'm going to walk up this and try to hit him with a scar really quick. I suck. That was really bad. I'm just going to go over him quickly. There we go. Gave me a second to get above him, pulled that pump out, and that was all she wrote. We got one more group fighting over there. Have a guy maybe on top of depot. Got to keep track of him. But DPI does matter. So if you are not sure what your DPI is, that could make a big difference on what your sensitivity is. So if people are telling you, oh, I play on this or that, and you don't know their DPI, it really doesn't have any type of relevance to you because... You know, if someone's playing on the same sensitivity as me, but with 1600 DPI, they're two times quicker. So it's important to know what your DPI is. You can do that with a lot of gaming mouses. If you don't know that, then just, like I said, find a sensitivity you're comfortable with. Don't follow anybody else's guidance on that. Because if you don't know their DPI, you don't know your DPI, you can't match them up anyway. So, let's see. One more down there. I can hear him. I can't see him, though. He's hiding, like, right there. Where you at, buddy? Where you at? Once you're comfortable going for body shots, by the way, I wanted to mention this, too. I didn't start off going for headshots all the time with snipers and stuff, so... We're gonna challenge him now. Couldn't pull the pump out quick enough and fire it. Took too long. No worries, though. Once you're comfortable going for body shots, then you can kind of go for headshots more often. I see a lot of people like, oh, man, what a great shot. It was a good headshot. I did not go for headshots, like, at all for the longest time because I just couldn't really hit them very well. I aimed for mainly body shots consistently. And at the point that I felt like I was hitting a lot of body shots, I started to say, you know, I'm going to go for more headshots because I feel like... It will help me get a lot more kills easier, and it helps a lot in the ways that you don't even think about. A great example of that is sometimes if you get into fights with people who have a lot of shield, you can body shot, body shot, body shot. They just back up and heal, back up and heal, back up and heal. And they keep using all their shields, which means you don't have any shields when you end up killing them. And, you know, that's a downside. You want to get the shield off them if you can. Another example is if you get into a build fight with somebody, if you take a long time to kill them and a lot of build is used from both of you guys... When you kill them eventually, if you do, they're not going to have any build to give you. So you want to eliminate them pretty quickly. That way you actually have stuff to take from them that are going to... It's going to be beneficial for you. Let's build up over here. Let's make it so people don't see where it is exactly. In case they are over there and they see it, it should hit them. We have 5 people remaining. 9 kills, not too shabby. So just a quick recap for you. There's a guy in the tree. Find a sensitivity you're comfortable with. Don't change it every day because that makes it a lot harder to get comfortable and remain consistent. We're going to go down for these guys. They're all fighting here. One has a rocket launcher as well. A gaming mouse computer in general will help you a lot with better frame rate. We're going to come up and try to snake a few kills out of this for sure. got him. This guy shouldn't be able to get me. Put a wall in front of that. Easy enough. And now it is a 1v1. A lot of shit went down over here. SMGs are really, really good when it comes to destroying walls. Really good. Or, in that case, a tree. It lets you conserve ammo for your main weapon, your assault rifle, while still destroying a tree in a really well, or really, let's say, timely manner. At that range, I can ADS with an SMG. A lot of times, though, I can't because, man, that stuttering sucks. People get too close of range. Ooh, hello. When people are right on top of me, there's just no way I can keep up with the turn speed. So, that's when you see me hip fire. Well, up there is definitely height advantage, which is nice, but if you look at the whole circle, just the tiny edge of it is in that, or on that hill. So it actually isn't that beneficial to be up there, honestly. He might be able to stay up there for this circle, which he didn't want to. There we go, easy enough. But, he get pushed off the second circle anyway, or the next circle after. So no big deal. I hope that helped though. I hope I gave you some tips or some advice that you maybe didn't know about. It is gonna come down to a lot of playtime in general to get comfortable with it. When it comes to aiming with snipers and stuff, lead time, that's just practice. I mean, that's just practice. I still suck giant balls with a hunting rifle and I wish I was good with it. So that requires more practice for me to get good with that gun. I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And until then, goodbye.